We need to hurry and get to the Hattis mansion early. I still need to drop by the shop to get the fabrics needed for his new suit. Waste no time, you know he has a bad temper.
Yes, father.
I'm so happy of what I have dreamt. I was reforming and there was dancing and singing.
Shh. How many times I have to tell you that singing cannot provide for us. This dress making alone almost cannot feed us both. Enough of that nonsense. Now, come on.
Arm extended, elbow out, sit, and never stir. Begin here. Arm extended, elbow out, keep your cup level, blow your cup. Shall we do it again? Arm extended, elbow out, raise your knee.
Charity, come here. Your dress. Is this how we taught you to behave?
It's my fault, sir. I made her laugh.
Well, thank you for your honesty. Stay away from my daughter. I don't like you socializing with lower lives, especially that tailor's son, Charity. They are not one of us. Remember that.
My fault.
I don't know what my future will be.
Why not? You belong to a well-off family. You should not really worry.
Father is sending me to finish his home. I don't want to be there.
I want to study too, but that will never just happen. I only hold these dreams in my head and see them when I sleep.
I close my eyes and I can see the world is waiting for me that I call my home. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy.
I will give you a life as grand as this one.
Goodbye, Mother.
She'll be back. Sooner or later, she'll be tired of life, of having nothing, and she'll keep running back home.
Sir, I'm Phineas Taylor Barton. If I may, sir, I believe I have skills and ideas that go well beyond counting numbers into an adding machine. If you were to apply that to this business, it would be ground.
Gentlemen, can I have your attention? You are all dismissed.
Bankrupt? I thought the company had a dozen trading ships.
Yes, at the bottom of the South China Sea, a typhoon sank them all.
And until further notice.
I didn't think you were alone for the job.
Or any job, apparently. Charity, this isn't the life I promised you.
That's what makes our life together so exciting. And I have everything I want.
What about magic?
What do you call those two girls? Hey, you partners, look who.
Daddy, did you bring a present?
Present? For what?
For my birthday.
Your what? Okay, I do have a present. But not just any present. Oh no, the most amazing birthday present ever. This extraordinary machine was originally created by Leonardo da Vinci 400 years ago. But the blueprints have been lost for centuries. Until just last week, the blueprints crossed my desk very briefly, but I managed to commit them to memory. If I had remembered correctly, happy birthday, Caroline. This is a wishing machine. You tell it your wishes, and it keeps them safe until they come true. Even if you forget them, they're always there.
Can I tell a wish?
Step right up. Go ahead.
I wish to marry Santa Claus.
That is a good wish.
I wish for ballet slippers.
Hey, that's a good wish too.
What is your wish, Mommy?
I wish for happiness like this forever. For you, and for your father.
Ever been born.
We're leaving. This bank only wants to lend money to people with money.
What are you looking at, Doom?
Mr. Warden, this venture you propose is risky and somewhat bizarre.
It's a good bet.
It's what it is, sir. People don't want to admit it, but they are fascinated by the exotic. That is why you stare at it.
The bank is going to need substantial collateral.
Of course, I would not suggest otherwise. The deed and title to my entire fleet of trading vessels.
Why would a bank lend us $10,000?
Because we booked up collateral.
We don't have any collateral.
Sure we do. Deep in the South China Seas.
Deep in the South China Seas? And what did we buy with this loan?
Barnum's American Museum
of Curiosity. What kind of museum is it?
A place where people can see things they've never seen before.
Wax figures?
Yes, they're all the rage in Europe. Look. Marie Antoinette with a sore throat. There's Napoleon, but they're not all wax. This is the great O'Malley. Master of sleight of hand, the king of deception.
You don't look like a magician.
I am a thief. A very good thief.
I am one.
What if this doesn't sell to the public?
I know how it works. I mean, it just needs a little work.
The loan has to be paid back every month.
Oh yes, we're going to pay. We just need customers.
Hundreds of them.
We're going to get them.
Welcome to the Barnum Museum. It is 1 hour of your time, sir, but the experience will change your life. We have a show every hour, surely not for the faint heart. I can tell you that you will love it. Ho ho! Welcome to the Barnum Museum!
How many tickets were sold, Mr. O'Malley?
Three.
Three?
Daddy, you sell any more tickets today?
A few. Most of them are rushing them. It's Friday.
I think you have too many dead things in your museum, Daddy.
She's right. You need something alive. Something sensational.
That is a big word.
That's your word. Something that isn't stuffed.
Like a mermaid or a unicorn.
Unicorns aren't real.
Well, mermaids aren't real either.
You must be Mrs. Stratton. I'm looking for your son.
I don't have a son.
The hospital record says you do. Charles Wright, age of 22.
Charles?
P.T. Barnum, at your service. I'm putting together a show, and I need a star.
You want people to laugh at me?
Well, you're laughing at me, so might as well get paid. I see a soldier. No, a general riding across the stage with a sword and a gun, the most beautiful uniform. People will come from all over the world, and when they see him, they will laugh. They will salute.
Curiosity, daring acts, wonders of the world.
How's it looking, girls?
Hey, looking for freaks? I know where I can find one of them.
Really? Come on, girls. Hello? I'm sorry. Who's doing that singing? It's you, isn't it?
Sir, I'll have to ask you to leave.
Oh, you are so talented. Blessed, extraordinary, unique. I would even say beautiful.
Sir, please leave me alone.
They don't understand it, but they will.
Brother and sister,
Yes, sir.
Terrific. And what do you do?
Trapeze.
Trapeze, okay.
You know, people are not going to like it if you put us on the stage.
Oh, I am counting on it. Next, tattoos on your entire body?
Yes, entire body.
Fantastic. Next, can I just ask how heavy you are? Do you have a number for that?
I prefer not to say it, but...
just between you and me,
750 pounds.
750 pounds? Is what you said? What's your name?
My name is Malcolm, sir.
Yes, but that's too difficult to say. We're going to change the name. I think you're Irish. Irish Giant.
Yes, now we have a show.
Men suffer more from imagining too little than too much.
The cream of a true frog.
Mr. Bennett, when was the last time you smiled?
or had a good laugh. A real laugh. A theater critic who can't find joy in the theater? Now who is the fraud?
Makarelate ang society, ba?
This way.
Don't you think there's enough blind trust in Waylon?
Well, isn't that what makes it fun? Okay, are you ready? Come on, let's go! Helen, that's for you. And Caroline, this is for you. There's a ballet school right down the street.
Thank you, Daddy!
Don't tell me you bought this house just to rub my parents' nose in your success.
That was not the only reason. This is the life I promised you. Shall we?
Finn, it's beautiful. But we don't need all of this.
It took me 25 years. But welcome home, Charity Barton.
Ew, something does now. I know where it is.
prima ballerina in the history of Cine Madrid.
I'm quitting.
What? Why would you quit?
I started too late. I will never catch up.
Caroline, you're the best dancer in the stage. What? You think I can't spot talent?
Ballet takes years of hard work. It's not like the circus. You can't just fake it.
She can't quit. No, I mean, she doesn't.
She just fills out the face with the other girls.
But those prima donnas are the most important thing in the world to her right now.
I have never seen so many little prima donnas in my life. She learned to ignore those girls and their kinds, just like I did.
She shouldn't have to.
New York society will never accept us. If they did, they'd have to stop judging and actually do something with their lives.
This isn't about me.
Oh, so it's different than everything else then?
I just want her to be proud of who she is, of her family.
She is proud. We don't have to be the Carlisles or any other lovely families.
Mr. Carlisle, you need this way?
Yes, I do. Indeed. Refunds are available at the front box office.
Haha, it's party.
From the circus?
Yes. You've been?
God, no. But I've seen crowds. People leave your show earlier than they came in.
And yet, you have no trouble selling tickets.
That's because I'm still a virgin.
Can I buy you a drink? I want to go after the Paris Strait. He's under some attacks. It's my appeal. Go after the rich snobs.
If you only knew how suffocating they are.
So come join the circus. You clearly have a fair show for business. Teach me how to appeal to the members.
Are you serious? Mr. Bonner, how can I just run off on the circus?
Why not? Sounds thrilling, isn't it?
Let's just say that I find it much more comfortable admiring your show from afar.
Comfort? The enemy of progress.
Do you understand that just associating with you could cost me my inheritance?
I thought it cost you more than that. But, on the other hand, why do you find yourself a free man?